Hello everyone, it's me, Tom, DJ Productions, here for another vlog. The date today is the 24th of April 2017, and a couple of little things today. There's a special announcement I got, but I'll get to that in a minute, because first of all I need to do my patron role, as I always do. So, let's see. So far, according to the coffers on Patreon, we together have raised £1,206, which is, in Patreon terms, $1,546. Now, that's because of the exchange rate at the moment. So, yeah, that's fantastic. That is helpful. And that will do great for the future. Still need to speak to Gwion about the specs for the computer, still, because I think every time I talk to him about it, he increases the specs ever so slightly every time. So, yeah, it's still looking like it's going to be a little while till we get to that stage where we can start ordering parts. Although I've said I could probably start ordering parts now, but, well, it's a case of waiting until I get the go-ahead to go and do so. So, yeah, we've still got quite a few patrons. So, thank you everyone who is still contributing to the Patreon campaign. And also thank you to everybody who has contributed in the past to the Patreon campaign. Now, on to my sort of special announcement-ish, I guess. Now, I've got an idea, because you patrons out there, you, my patrons, haven't really given you much of any sort of bonuses or anything, I'm afraid to say, because I'm not very good at that sort of thing, I'm afraid. So, I've had a little think, and I think I know how to rectify that ickle problem. Now, this will only be available to people who are currently patrons, because I can't go back and see who have previously paid in. So now is a great time to start being a patron. Now is a great time to be a patron because I've written, let's see, I'm four and a half scripts into writing. I've recorded the first script because it's, you know, the, you know, first episode of the season. So I've recorded that. I'm probably going to be working on an intro today. And then maybe start some filming for the first episode and, you know, doing the editing for the music. Now, what I thought is, for current patrons only, I'm afraid, because of complicated things I have to go through. I mean, I can't email all past patrons, I'm afraid. I've decided to do everyone a little sort of nice thing, which is that if you're a current patron, when I finish an episode of TDRS, Season 7, anyway, I'll upload it. And not put the monetization on. Now, what I'm thinking of doing is either a week or 2 weeks where I'll email out, well, via Patreon, so you'll have to check your Patreon, I'll send out the link for it, it's unlisted, so it's only for you guys, because I can't think of a better way to do it unless I just send it to all your email addresses that are currently popping up on Patreon. I'd like some feedback from that, from the patrons themselves, so if someone of you could get in contact with me, that'd be great, about how they want me to go about this. Do you want a private link sent via Patreon, or would you rather have it via an email? But anyway, you'll get exclusive access to each episode, a week or 2 weeks, depending on which one I decide on, or what you guys think, without adverts, before the public. That's my way of saying thank you, because I can't think of a better way to do so. And, of course, all my ideas for videos seem to be going floppy-doppy at the moment because I keep thinking, right, I'm going to do a special video for the patrons, something different, something unique, and I haven't really got any ideas. Well, it's funny, actually, because I've got ideas, it's just putting them into practice. But, essentially, long story short, if you're currently a .DJ Productions patron, you will get access to each episode a week or two before the public, without adverts. Because what will happen after that 2 weeks... Also, I'll go onto the video, make it public, and put the adverts on because, well, you know, I need to make some ad revenue in general. The only other idea I had was to keep one unlisted and upload a second copy, but that would bloat my channel a little bit. And also, it would stagger views, I think, because I'd like to keep the views all together. And plus, the funny thing is, if I have it as a patron, so I know how many of my patrons have actually watched it. The only other thing I was wondering was, with that same token, my friends, because, for example, there's one person in particular I'd like to watch an episode beforehand, which is Anthony Sims. Now, he can't currently afford to be a patron, but he has done, for example, the artwork for the, if I just lift my mouse mat up a sec, well, actually, if I just put my camera back to there, Anthony Sims is the gentleman who did the artwork for me for Sid, for the merchandise that we've been putting out, which I'll talk to again about properly in a minute, because there's something else I need to talk about, the merchandise. So I'm thinking Anthony will probably get special access as well, despite not being a patron, because, well, at the end of the day, he's been one of my longest supporters, and a big shout out to you, Anthony, if you're watching this. We naturally need to properly meet, though, at some point, because I'm getting fed up with knowing you via the computer, and actually talking to you pretty much every, you know, couple of days, but never actually of seeing you. So, yeah, get your ass down here, or we'll try and meet in the middle at some sort of railway, or some bollocks, I don't know. But anyway, that's my idea for some sort of bonus for the patrons. It's not obviously written up on the Patreon, because, well, to be honest, I don't really monitor Patreon every day, and plus, I can't really think of a good way of doing awards. Although I did wonder whether to do another tier of the Patreon, because at the moment all we've got is no reward, which is for people who like started off ages ago, and then the $1 award, which is being mentioned on the Roll of Honor, which, you know, I try and update every month or so, if I can remember. So yeah, that's my idea for that. If you are a patron, then do get in touch about that. If you're thinking of becoming a patron, so you can get access to episodes before everyone else, then donate as little or as much as you like, to be honest, because at the end of the day, any support is great, and these sort of little incentives give me other good ideas as well. Because obviously, if I see a massive influx in patrons after this video, because people want access to early access, basically, then I'll try and do more early access stuff for the patrons, because that's a good way of getting people on board. And I'm trying to make a sort of community out of it, because I know we've got the DDJP group on Facebook, which is a little community, and then we've got the Discord server, which, to be honest, I'm actually considering making a Dark DJ production official server, but I'll speak to my mates about that later on, because Sim Nation server has gone a bit quiet, and I think if we had one specifically for Dark DJ Productions, that might be nice, because you guys could actually speak to me normally. Because, yeah, as long as people aren't cringy, because I've had a couple of instances recently where I've had cringy people talking to me. Yeah, I don't do well with cringy people. I remember one incident when I was at a railway. I'm not going to mention any names, but people who know me probably know who I'm talking about, where I had a panic attack on a train, because a fan, aka, or someone I knew from a group, kept getting unusually close to me and making me feel really uncomfortable, and at one point I had to run up halfway up the train and hang out a window to get my breath back, so I was just panicking, because I was like, I don't like that sort of interaction. But talking to people via Discord would be fine. So yeah, there's a possibility I'm going to set up a Discord server. If people think that's a good idea, then obviously please reply to the video. So yeah, that's sort of my Patreon news. I just wanted to mention as well, if you haven't seen already, well, you probably have because you're watching my channel, I've tried the S15 out. Now, I'm probably going to be installing somebody's informed me that there's actually now a sound pack for that, utilising the SSS King Arthur sound pack, which, you know, I think it's just a case of aliasing the sounds. So I think I'm going to try that out and maybe give that another run, because if I am going to include an S15 in the next season, which I would really like to, it needs to have better sounds, because I don't like the default whistle on it. And some of the other sounds are right, but they're just, I don't know, they're a bit generic, I guess. I mean, I know S15s are sort of a bit of a generic freight engine, but although I say that, it's not very often you see a 460 freight engine, is it? I mean, they've got mixed traffic, but not really a 460 freight. Anyway, so that's sort of like patron news, and that's video news. Well, it's not really video news, is it? I need to think of some other things to write to talk about video news. Oh, that's it. Darkcasts. You might have noticed that they've stopped a little bit. That is mainly because, one, we haven't really had many subjects to talk about, because there's not really any news in the railway world at the moment, and we haven't really had the people, because that's the other thing, we haven't had enough people around on the Discord server. That is another reason why I'm thinking of making a DDJP server, so we can have a room specifically for Darkcasts if they want to continue. But again, as I usually keep saying, if you do have a comment about the Darkcasts and whether you want to see them continue, or even if you want to take part, then leave a comment in the video. Yeah, because I sort of like doing them. They're like a radio show, and I you know, me and my music background, I like doing stuff like that. And as you can tell from the vlogs, I like talking rather a lot, which I know can get a bit grating. Just something else. Well, I'm not going to wear my my Sid t-shirt. I have actually got it over here. If I grab it, I was, oh my God, because I wore this up to Didcot last week or the week before. I've got my shirt here. You're welcome. You're welcome, of course. But I was going to wear it, but it doesn't show up where we've gone on the camera. And the way I'm sitting, if I just put that back on the sofa, the way I sit, you can't really see where the logo is. So I didn't really see the point. And plus, my Purple Man shirt is cool. Although I was wondering whether to make some merchandise out. Ah, merchandise. Yes. You may have noticed that I've stopped sort of asking about that on Facebook. That's because, as with these experiments, I didn't really get that much interest, to be honest. I got, like, maybe about 10 people, I think, asked for a bit of merchandise, you know. I've got the last bits of merchandise sat over there waiting until I can actually afford to go out and get some postage stuff, because I kind of haven't got anything to post them in yet, and I'm waiting until I get paid at the end of this week or next week, depending which one. And then I will let you guys know when I'm sending that. That's to Chris Rasmussen, Oliver Pocock, Gareth Dobson, and Vincent Briggins, if they're watching. I really bloody hope that the postcodes and addresses are correct, because they're all foreign apart from Gareth. I need to send one to Australia, one to Norway, and one to America, so that's going to be fun. But yeah, no, there is another reason why I've stopped with the merchandise at present. One, I'd like to maybe think about opening a shop at some point, but I'm a bit worried about the tax man, so I'm probably not going to bother with that. And the other reason is, I've actually worked it out, I'm a bit of an idiot, and I've made a loss on everything I've sold so far. Because idiot here didn't actually appreciate the fact that I wouldn't need such a big parcel to send the shirts and mouse mats in, so I bought massive ones, because I thought, Christ, I better get something big enough. And then I was informed at the post office that I actually needed something smaller anyway. But they'd send it this time, but next time to send them in something smaller if they're just t-shirts. And then the postage increased significantly because of the size of the parcel. Don't worry to everyone who bought one, I'm not going to ask for any more money. That's not how I roll. Plus, most people have paid via the Patreon anyway, so, you know, soz to myself, I guess. But, yeah. That's why I'm not going to do any more merchandise. The only thing I might do, perhaps, is... because, obviously, this artwork, I can't just leave it to, you know, rot away forever. I'll probably do another run in the future, possibly, of pens. Because I was thinking, for the Patreons, if you donate something like, I don't know, $5 or more, you get the Roll of Honour and a free pen. But, I don't know. That depends what the Patrons think and what people who are actually wanting to come onto Patreon think. Because, at the end of the day, it's about you guys as well. Because I make these videos and make this stuff for you lot. And for my own, I mean, I don't know, for my own personal enjoyment, because I love making my series, but I do make it well to entertain. That's the whole point. It's to entertain. It normally entertains me more than anyone, because, funny story, I was sat waiting to go to work the other day, and I was watching the whole Reel of Ed and Sid, and I'm pissing myself, some of them. Some of them are just so freaking stupid. Like, what was it? Which one was it? Oh, that's it. The one where the foreign one around the world, episode 3, when they go off somewhere and it's raining, and Ed's like, right, we're going to sit down, we'll have a couple of bevvies and enjoy the lovely breeze. And then Sid just turns around and goes, Ed, it's fucking raining! It's like, I don't know why that was funny, but it was. Which brings me sort of quite neatly onto news anyway about seasons and series and things, because that's what you're here for, probably. Not for the silly Dart DJ Productions logo or my ugly mug. Because look at this beard. It's getting very big. I need to get it trimmed, because it's starting to get... Look, it's literally taking up about half my head. Half my head is hair. I mean, look at my hair. I do not like it. I need it cut, because I don't like it when it flaps over my head. I like it up. Anyway, sorry, enough about me. Yeah, season news. First of all, as I said at the beginning of the video, TDRS Season 7 is on the way. Episode 1 I'm going to be hopefully recording this week. But that's sort of troublesome because I'm at work every day this week apart from today. I'm working 14 days, and of those 14 days I get one day off, which is today. So I'm catching up on stuff, and I've done some housework. When I say housework, I've done the washing up, haven't really done much else. And I've taken the recycling bin down, and I've dropped people off to work, and now I'm waiting to, well, a couple of hours' time, I've got to go pick them up again. Hey! I've got episode 1 sorted out. I've recorded the audio for that. To be honest, I was thinking I might actually sit here and do some... Sorry, the screen's shaking, by the way. I keep shaking my legs and shaking the computer. Episode 1, yeah, I've got that recorded. I might record some more today. The problem is I've got... Because voice actor-wise, I've got... I've selected one person to voice number 5. Well, 5 as he's going to be known, because... I'll tell the story, okay. So, as you guys might know, there's the Dark Railway Preservation Society, which is like a background group for supporting the series. Like, you know, they're people who say they're doing things around the railway, like, I don't know, signalling or track maintenance. That seems to be the main thing people are doing at the moment, track maintenance, P-Way. And we bought a locomotive called Five. Well, his number's Five. He's Backwell, Kenningham, Fortbridge and Colliery number Five, which is the fictional colliery system that I'm planning on having some engines appear from in the future, including Backwell, the 060 outside cylinder, Robin Stevenson, the Hornthorn loco, Gamma, who Sam Logan has kindly agreed to voice if I introduce him, and maybe some other engines. Like, I'm actually considering writing this into maybe season 7 if I can get away with it, because I'll explain more in a minute. But anyway, so number 5 and coming to live on the railway, or 5, the reason I haven't given him a name, he's known by number, is one, it's a reference to the Fowler 4Fs, because there was a character in there called number 5, and secondly, well, we did a poll, and the leading result on the poll was for the engine to be called Zeke, which would be named in honour of Mr. Dark's son, Zeke Dark. Now, the issue with that is, I've already got Mr. Dark and Otto the Tank Engine, who have both got the same first name, which is Faniel, or Otto. You've got Mr. Smash and his locomotive, number 70047, Character Smash. So there's already two characters there with the same name. So I thought maybe having a third one, having number 5 named after Zeke, might be a bit confusing, because then you'd have Zeke the Tank Engine and Zeke the Mr. Dark Sun, because I do intend to introduce Mr. Dark Sun this season. The story will come out eventually, but essentially he's coming to learn a bit more about the railway, because he's been off to boarding school and he's an apprentice with Mr. Smash. So he's an engineer, so he's going to basically be coming in and doing engineering work around with the engines. So yeah, I've gone really off tangent, haven't I? I do this a lot. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, so I've selected a voice actor for number 5, because he has a few... He doesn't really have... I'm afraid to say, he doesn't really have big roles. Because I've basically broadened it a lot this season. Like, there's a lot of things going on because of... As you'll see in the season. But I've selected Stuart Steele to voice number 5, because he is a Scottish-built locomotive, and I don't have enough Scottish voice actors, and I do like some of my Scottish voice actors, who I listen to anyway. So yeah, he's got a voice actor. I'm looking at getting 3 more voice actors for an episode, which is a fireman, a driver, and a guard for the 3rd episode. So I'm going to be sourcing some voice actors for that soon. And, I've already started writing episode 5, Barry. Barry is coming, and he's fucking mental. And Anthony Sims, I hope, will do a really good job, because I've written his lines, but I'm hoping that... I mean, when I speak to Anthony, I'll say to him, look, I'm writing this, but he's probably listening to this before he talks to me anyway, so what I'm going to do is write the lines in, but if he thinks he can improve them in any way, in Barry's style, considering how the scripts go, or even if he's got some input in, then let me know. If he gets the script and decides to do, like, the line that I've written, and then an alternate line, I'll listen to the two and decide which one I've liked the best. Because that's the way I'm going to roll with Barry, because I think having Anthony on as a voice actor, it deserves some creative, because he's the one who actually came up with the whole voice for Barry, which, as you might have heard in some calls and things before, actually, the best example is in Gary the Steam Engine. There's a character, there's a Q1 that just randomly goes oop. That is the accent that Anthony's using. It's like Lancashire, I think, or Yorkshire. I think it's more Lanx. Then again, he is Lanx, so yeah. So Barry's coming. What other characters? So yeah, we've got 70047 coming, finally. Number 5, Barry. And then some very special ones that I've got that... I've had to shake this around a bit. It's still questionable how much of this is going to happen, because originally I intended to have a story where the Terriers that are coming out, which I'm going to be doing a Dark Tries of when they released, there's a particular one called Cheapside. And I wrote, as you might have seen on YouTube ages ago, there was a thing called Cheapside's Fate with the old DT Terrier, I think it was DT. No, it wasn't DT, it was a freeware one. And Cheapside gets destroyed. And I wrote a whole story about how Cheapside was bought by Lord Dark in the 1910s, on the cheap side, of course, because he had some faults, and he was destroyed in an accident. Now, I've retconned that, because now the new models of Terriers, I might as well take advantage of having some new Southern stock, hence why I said about the S15. So hopefully we're going to have a Terrier on the DR. Now, you might be thinking, wait a sec, the DR is all hills. There's not really any branch lines. Well, there may be some branch lines in the future. I've got a plan to talk about the DRPS guys about the Mirkum Industrial Railway, which is possibly going to be a rebuild of the Mirkum Industrial Branch. Only from Manston 4-ish down to Mirkum Industrial Park, as it's going to be called, and then a museum at the gasworks. You see, what I'm intending to do eventually is expand the railway to have more in the way of museum, because I've already got a good plan for Gallon Junction, because at the moment it's a wasteland and we need to get some more visitors at Gallon Junction. But at the Mirkum end of the line, I'm thinking what we'll do is maybe I'm going to see about possibly trying to rebuild part of the line so there could be an interchange between the Mirkum Industrial Railway, where number 5 is intending to live at some point, and some other engine may live, including the Backwell engine, possibly, and the Abomination. An interchange between the two stations, because the idea is that, like, originally they start and they can only run from a place called Manston 4 Two Bridges, which is a station between the two bridges that go over the railway, the road bridge and the rail bridge. And then it's eventually extended to join back up to the DR at the old junction. But that's one idea for a branch line. I'm thinking of building another one at Manning's Heath, which is a station beyond Coalhapper. But anyway, I've gone off track again. Sorry, guys. I've got no one to tell me to stay on track. Stay on track. The idea was with this, obviously, the new Terrier coming out, that I would use it maybe, because in the future, obviously, from Coalhapper, the railway will eventually get all of Coalhapper Station and all of the line to Barbourne, but that's a long story. But there's also the branch to Horton, which is the main line connection at that end. Because if you come off from Coalhapper, as you might have seen in some of my other videos, there's a triangle. It may not be a triangle all the time because of the sharpness of one of the curves. Might have to rebuild that. Or something, I don't know. But anyway, there's a branch that goes off to this place called Horton, which is a really massive southeastern Chapman station, which is so big because it's a big spiralling junction for many other lines in my fictional history. Like, a line goes up north towards a place called Market Labour and then Ramsgate and Margate. There's a line going south towards Hastings. This is all giving you a location of where the DR is. It's basically slap bang in the middle of Kent. I've made Kent a bit bigger in my fictional universe to facilitate it, but who gives a crap? But yeah, anyway, off track again. Cheapside, being a small little terrier, would most likely be used for shuttle services between Coalhapper and Horton, because it's not that long a distance, about 5 miles, and there's not much in the way of big hills, I don't think. It's relatively flat. Although I'd say that there's a really big hill coming out of Horton. So yeah, that's the idea for having Cheapside in. I've retconned that so that he, instead of being destroyed, he was rebuilt as an A1X. And also he was built with an extended bunker, if I can get that to work. Like the Isle of Wight engines. And then he is somehow managing to be purchased by Mr. Smash. He ends up in the back of his yard, forgotten about for so long. And then Zeke obviously met the Dark Sun. He realises what the engine is and he decides to buy him and then present him to the railway as a present to his dad, even though his dad never knew Cheapside. And he probably thinks he's a replica at first. But yeah, my intention is to get some more Southern logos in, because at the moment all I've introduced is 2BR standards in the scripts. Now, there's an interesting one, because I don't know whether they're going to be all owned by Mr. Dark or whether it's going to be some sort of like Maunsell Locomotive Society. I think there's already a locomotive society called the Maunsell Locomotive Society, but it might be something like the Southern Era Preservation Society. I'll have to talk about this with some friends, or if you've got any comments, again, put them on the video, because I like to spoil everything for everyone, basically. But obviously, you have to read this. You have to actually watch the episode to get a good idea of what's going on, and it's all quite amusing. Sort of, and the stories are alright, I guess. They're just stories. Although episode 4... Shite, what was episode 4? Oh, I can't remember what episode 4 is. Oh, I know what it is. It's the Road to Coalhapper. Yeah, okay, anyway. My intention to have an S15, as I said. It would obviously be about smoke deflecting, because I don't like smoke deflectors on Southern logos. I haven't got a name for it yet. But I have got two other ones with names. There'd be three Maunsell engines, basically. One of them is obviously the S15, which I need to think of a name for. And then there's a school class called Downside, and the amusing joke there is that the engines all be sat in the shed laughing about something, and then like Downside would come in, and one of the engines might call out, "Oh look, there's an upside, and then there's you." And then he'd be pissed off, basically. But anyway, so you'd have Downside, who'd probably be quite an intelligent engine, seeing as he's a schools. But then you've got what Anthony keeps calling the Southern Supremacist, which is an N15 by the name of Sir Maddle Delaporte. I don't know how to pronounce that properly. It might be Sir Maddle Delaporte. But that's an N15, which I'm again having without smoke deflecting because I'm using the SLC N15, which I've discovered recently on the engine which have the vacuum crosshead equipment, the injectors don't work. So if anyone actually has tried to drive those and can get the injectors to work, then please do let me know because I want to change the scripts if I can. So at the moment, it looks like this engine is going to be appearing in early British Railways transitional to match 257 when he comes back, because I'm thinking this season's going to have more than 10 episodes. It's going to have to. Otherwise, I'm going to cram everything into such a small space. It's going to be unreal. But his name is Della Tripp. I've got a backstory for why he's called Della Tripp. His name is Sir Maddle Delaporte, but every time he went out with his crews, they'd always make a joke saying, "Oh, we're going out on a Della Tripp," or "We're going out on Della Tripp, Ralph on a trip," sort of la ha ha, and that just became his name, Della Tripp. It's also named after one of my favourite songs from Ian Pooley called Della Tripp, and I just think it's a bit of an interesting, strange name, isn't it? Della Tripp, or Tripp, I suppose it'd be called, but no, probably just be continue being called Della Tripp, unless, of course, you're Barry, and you'll be like, "Hey, Orp, it's trippy, he's being a bit trippy again, doo-doo. I can't do Lang, sorry, Anthony." But there's also the introduction of possibly a diesel, another a new diesel locomotive or two, D1017 Warrior, which Anthony will probably laugh at because he'll probably want to voice it, and maybe Clyde will come back for extra help because Clyde is a Scottish 37 who he appeared in I think it's not Asphalt Soul, it's Burning last season, and I promised Callum Hancock, my voice actor, that he could voice him if I introduce him in the future, so he might come in this season because I'm doing a bit of time skipping this season. Because I want to get sort of not to present day, but like to the 80s and the 90s. And I just think the 70s in preserved railways was sort of interesting. But in order to introduce a load of engines, I need to increase the time scripting on this. God, I've been talking for so long already. So yeah, that's basically my idea for introduction of characters. Zeke Dark will finally be introduced, as I promised last season and forgot to do that because of obviously the big storyline that was going on. And basically the railway's changing quite a bit because it's gone from sort of trying to become a premier line into actually becoming a premier line because we finally got the double track sorted out. But some of the stations need to be rebuilt and actually going back to its familiar shape with its overall roof, as you'll see in episode 2. Gallen Junction is also being rebuilt to have the main line platform being the main platforms and the bay platform be a bay platform for future reference. And then obviously the line down to Coalhapple, we've got one platform down there, but that'll all be explained in the first episode because, you know, isms. Now, my battery's starting to run out, so I'm going to move on because I've already given away probably too many spoilers for season 7. However, you'll just have to watch it and see what happens. Because there's a funny storyline about Della Tripp being a Southern supremacist, and he hates everything that isn't Southern. So he despises everybody on the railway, even though Phil and Otto try and point out that they've actually worked on the Southern region all their life, but he doesn't care because they're not Southern region designed. But then it'll be found out that all this time Della Tripp's been going on about that, and he is a North British built locomotive, so he's built in Scotland, so he is actually a massive bellend. And if anything, he should actually appreciate the... he should actually appreciate number 5 more because he's a fellow Scot, if you like. Anyway, okay, I'm going to have to plug my battery in because... Eh. Otherwise, I'm going to... Oh, God, the screen's gone bright again. I did turn the brightness right down. In fact, let me do it again. There we go. So that I don't get too much glare off my glasses. Okay, so I've done a lot of talking about TDRS. So what about my other project, Ed and Sid? Haven't written anything for Ed and Sid yet. But I'm just sort of like walking around at work and chilling at home thinking of ideas for Ed and Sid. I'll probably do another run of Ed and Sid for technically season 3, but Ed and Sid season 2 because obviously the original one called Ed the Engine. So yeah, we've got that going for us. We've got more Ed and Sid, hopefully. I may make those. Those, of course, will also probably be Patreon exclusive at first, like, you know, early access Patreon. Garuda Steam Engine. Now, I've had some really good news about Garuda Steam Engine. It's, as you may have gathered, me and Reese had a tiff because, you know, we're lovers and we have a love and tiff from now and again because we're both idiots and whatever. And I was a bit worried that I wouldn't be able to continue Garuda Steam Engine. I was a bit panicky about that because I was like, well, I thought I did such a good job at the first one. It would be a shame to let it all go to waste if I, you know, fucked up. But we've chatted about it, and I'm going to continue doing Garuda Steam Engine. I'm not going to go into details about what's actually happened or blah, blah, blah again. But, yeah, essentially, that'll be coming soon. I've already got the episode named, which is Cold Strike. And I've got some... I'm going to get some more voice acting in for that and finally get Bruce his... try and get Bruce his role as Cockade, because he wanted to be a warship. So Bruce, if you're watching this, yes, I'm going to try and write Cockade into the second episode when I got time, because I want to get season 7 written first, and also need to wait for Reed to come back before I write a script, because I want to chat with him about that. So yeah, Garuda Steam Engine is coming back. It's just going to take a while. I know I've not been very productive, despite my name, Productions. You know, where my beard is now, Productions. That aren't happening at the moment. I'm sorry, but I've had a bit of a life, big boo boo with my life, which is with someone in my house now working, we have lost most of our housing benefit. So I'm having to work a lot of overtime in order to actually afford to live, because we pay quite a bit for this house. Well, I say we pay quite a bit, we rent it, but I've been here so long, I don't really want to leave. I just want to refurbish the place looking at it, because this purple behind me I don't like. I want to get. Oh, what I want to do is get green or not green, maybe blue, white, I don't know. But a different colour anyway. So yeah, that's why I haven't been very productive, because I've been doing a lot of overtime in order to be able to afford to live. Now, I know that Oliver, for example, from Patreon campaign, said, oh, yeah, some of you use some of ours. No. Patreon money, that's it. I'm not doing that. Although people do want to give me a donation via PayPal to help me out of it, that'd be great. But no, I'm not asking properly anyone. But that's just the reason why I've been a bit quiet in Productions at the moment, because I haven't been able to just sit and do, because obviously I've got my darts league on a Tuesday night, so I can't usually... Although I'm coming to the summer, and I'm not sure I'm going to play the summer league, so I might be at home more on a Tuesday night. I've been busy sort of, because I've got to get my car sorted out soon as well. My dad's paying for that, thankfully. Got to get that MOT'd, so I can still get to work. Work's been a nightmare. I'm getting so exhausted at work. And I hate the fact that some days I'm going in and I'm in a bad mood, and I don't like being in a bad mood, but then maybe one or two customers will do something or say something that just tip me over the edge, and that leaves me in a bad mood for a while, but then luckily I do perk up. But it makes me mad that I get mad, if that makes sense, because I'm supposed to be a professional in customer service, and I do try and do my best. But when you're working so hard, and you're working a lot of hours... I say a lot of hours. It feels like a lot of hours because I don't really work that many hours normally, but now I'm working more hours. It does get exhausting. So I've been going to bed a lot earlier as well, and haven't been able to chat because of the girls watching TV and movies and things like that, and catching up on silly things like Vampire Diaries. And there's me meanwhile thinking, Christ, I could really do watching some QI or some Mock the Week. And then, we're watching TV tonight, and it's like, oh, thanks. And I'm like, oh, you could have gone upstairs, but I don't like going upstairs. I'm not comfortable up there. I'd much prefer sitting down here in my lounge. It's more comfy. God, have I just actually ranted about my life for a change? Jesus Christ, I don't normally do that. Normally, I'm like, I'm not going to talk about my life. I'm just going to talk about my productions. So I just thought I'd do a disgusting thing. Wow, this video has gone on for nearly 30... Nope, oh my goodness. We're 33 minutes, I think. Is it 33? Yeah, 33 minutes at the moment. So this is one of those longer vlogs. It's just me rambling. I remember the old random ramble. See, I'm just rambling again. Now, was there any other news I wanted to talk about? I've talked about the S15. Talked about the new engines that could be coming. Let's see. Oh, I've talked about merchandise. Oh, that's it. Complete. Oh god, excuse me, jeez, beg your pardon everybody. Reese mentioned it on Angry Welshman Productions. I haven't actually mentioned it anywhere yet, so I thought I might as well mention it here, because at this stage in the video everyone's probably bored and they've gone off to eat some bonbons, or you know, they've gone off for a cigarette like I really need to do in a minute, when I finish this video. and get it ready to upload. Or they've gone off to watch, you know, a rerun of a football match. I don't know what people do during the day. Or maybe they're just like, oh, it's time to go to work. Let's leave the video running. Anyway, but at this point, not many people are probably watching still because they're probably bored of me rambling. So, you know, again, in the comments, if you're here still, let me know you're actually listening to this bit. I've been talking to some people who are affiliated with Digital Traction, the, you know, game. They build models and they release, like, locomotives and rolling stock for Train Simulator 2017, which I'm sticking with rather than going over to Train Sim World because that looks rubbish. Anyway, that's for another video. We talked about that before. Anyway, we were sort of chatting, me and these guys, and it sort of came around to the conversation of my Dark Tries videos. And basically what we said was, I said, well, if you guys wanted me to, I could cover more of your stuff as it's released. And one thing led to another, and we've sort of come to an agreement, kind of, with me, as well as Reese, because Reese is in on this as well, because, you know, friends together, I guess, and it means we can be, you know, beta testers, but, well, not beta testers, we're, basically, what we're doing is running in trials, we're calling it. I might even change the, when I do one of these running in trials, I might actually do Dark's running in trials rather than Dark Tries. But essentially what I'm going to be doing is, and Reese as well, is essentially when a new model is nearly ready for release by Digital Tractions, we'll be getting a copy of it for free. I believe it's for free anyway, I might have to pay something, I don't know. Anyway, we're getting a copy of it for review purposes. It's almost a bit like, you know, when things get released early access, or when a game is ready for release on Steam, for example, and game review critics like Jim Sterling and Total Biscuit and people like that, they can get a review code and they do a review of it before it's even come out or on the day it comes out. This is sort of a similar thing, which is that me and Reese will be doing sort of like a running in trials, if you like, where we'll be having first access to it and we're allowed to make a video of it. Obviously, there's some restrictions, like, you know, for example, there's only a certain amount of people we could ever have in one of these calls if we needed some technical details talking about. Even though, you know, I fly solo with the Dark Tries, but, you know, it could be something with the running in trials when I'm getting working. I'll talk to the guys about that. So, yeah, it's sort of like, it sort of works both ways, because at one side, it's good for me because it's sort of an exclusive for my channel. I mean, no, I know Reese as well, but with Reese being at sea, once when things start rolling again, I'll be able to do a cover, like, you know, very first impression release. And then when Reese comes to try it himself, he'll probably do a more in-depth one. I'll talk to him about that, because we can possibly do something like that, or we can even do some together, because we're allowed to do that. So it's good for my channel, because it means people will come and, like, you know, they'll say, someone's actually got the first whatever it is from Digital Traction, let's go have a watch. So it helps with my channel, but on the flip side, it's helping Digital Traction as well, because if the people do watch the videos, and they'll go, oh, I really like the look of that, I should buy it, and then they'll go and pre-order or buy it from Digital Traction, and that increases sales for them. So it's views for me, sales for them, and Reese, of course. So I think that's a good idea. I like it. Whether you like it or not is a different story. Again, comment section if you have anything to say about that, and if people aren't bored to death by watching my ugly mug now. So that's sort of like an exclusive-ish thing that will be coming to my channel when stuff gets rolling, because I believe, now I'm not sure whether this is 100% yet, but I believe the first one of those I'll be doing might be the Digital Traction N2 that's coming out. I believe I'm allowed to say that. If I'm not, then I'm sure one of the guys will go, hey, you can't say that, and I'll just, like, have to come back and do another vlog and be, sorry, I wasn't allowed to say it at the N2, it's actually the well tank. There isn't really a well tank. I don't even know if anyone's building a well tank, but you know what I mean. So yeah, that'd be a nice little thing. Nice little season series sort of thing to start, maybe. Or it could just be a continuation of Dark Tries, because I usually do a Dark Tries whenever something gets released, and I'll just give it a bash. Obviously, I've got to be careful how I do these reviews, because how can I put this? I'm not a fan of the LNER, personally. There's a couple of engines I like from the LNER, normally the Gresley period. And as for the N2, I've never really been that partial to it. But my plan is to do a sort of an impartial review, like, you know, actually talk about the model itself, the functionality, the history, like I usually do, because I've even covered engines in the past, I don't like that much. But obviously, if I find anything buggy, because I've got to give it a try, if I find anything, it's not like doing a beta test as well, because if I find anything I don't think is quite right with it, I can feel comfortable reporting back to the guys and saying, look, this doesn't look right. Like, for example, if there's a valve animation off, I can say to that before the review, and then when I do the review, I can point out and say, look, I know there's this, but I've already discussed it with the developers. And if anyone watching the video sees any errors, then they obviously, if I pronounce whatever first, I'll just see how it goes when I get to it. And I think I've probably been talking for long enough now, 40 minutes. Whether you're actually going to sit and watch all of this, I don't know. I can't really think of anything else at present. Yeah, the merchandise, we've talked about that. There's a couple of things. Yeah, I've got that haul that I bought at Didcot the other week to modify at some point. Yeah, because I bought this haul. It's sort of like a half kit built model for £5. I wasn't going to scrap it, you know, make it into a scrap engine. But now I'm thinking what I might try and do is cosmetically restore it. All I need to get is some cylinders, bogey, valve gear, and then possibly some like Humboldt paint, and repaint the whole lot, because it's got an engine in tender for £5, double O gauge, not that bad. So that's this vlog, because I've talked for long enough now. So I'm going to go and do what I usually do and read through my current patrons, who, if they've watched this video, I hope they get back to me and tell me whether they like the idea of early access for any of my future sort of like TDRS and Ed and Sid productions. So, in no particular order, because it just goes from top to bottom, I'd like to thank the following people for joining the Patreon campaign. I hope to see more. I'd really like to introduce more people into this, because at the end of the day, it's helping me, and it means you guys get some extra sort of benefits eventually. So let's see, we've got David Seaward, Andrew Watson, Oliver Pocock, Bruce Astle, Hamish Scottford, Stuart Steele, Gareth Dobson, Joseph Brewer, Vincent Briggins, Bob Jones, Thomas Powell, aka the Red Crane, because I didn't know whether that's the right guy, but apparently he is, Sebastian Berthelsen, Brian McDonnell, Jeremy Bartus, Richie Sutton, and James Ellison. All of you, thank you for continuing to contribute to the Patreon. And I hope to see more people on the Patreon in the future, because the sooner we do that, the faster we get a new computer. And then, quite possibly, I might actually be able to get a high-def camera and do a nice vlog. And then I might actually be able to do a nice high-definition season of TDRS. Because Season 7 is now going to have to be done on this computer. Happy days! So, that's the end of this vlog. Thanks for watching, and sorry if I've been really freaking boring today. Bye!